Ladder Edition. Wow, this is one of, well, this is pretty much the biggest map at the moment, so this is a big one. Here we are, guys. Make sure everything is set up correct. It is 2-2. So spawning at the top right as the blue Zerg playing for Team Acer, it is Bly. And on the other side of the map, at the bottom right, as the Red Terran playing for Complexity, looking to take the advantage in this game, it is the STC. And like I said, you know, it's 2-2 now, so whoever takes this is at ace or match point and is going to be one game away from taking that 50. I'm pretty sure it's like 50 euros. So that's cool, man. Now the question is, what type of build will we be seeing out of the STC? Because like I said, game number one, it's always up to the Terran, pretty much, to do something to the Zerg. The Zerg is just like, yeah, like I want drones, just leave me alone for like 15 minutes and that's fine. Of course, the Terran does not want to do that, because then the drone, the Zerg will just kill him with far superior economy and tech. So yeah, we normally see some sort of gas. It will be a barracks, though, as we could see right below. Of course, if the SCV came back and stopped doing that little thing, that is going to be normally a command center first. And gas. So it is going to be Reapers. So far, the only game we haven't had Reapers is game number 4 on Daybreak. And when you have the control of the SDC, you can't be surprised when he goes Reapers so often. Like, that game number 2, man, those Reapers, yo. Hatch first, coming for Bly, which is what you always expect. On a map as big as this as well, he's not really going to go, you know, for that drone scout, because it's just going to take so long. He's got overlords in each position, and even if it was an 8-8 racks in the center of the maps, it's still, like, you know, that's still, like, the size of Cloud Kingdom. Like, in terms of, okay, maybe not Cloud Kingdom, but Neo Planet, maybe. No, actually, it's still not Neo Planet, but it's close. It's not, it's quite big, actually, I meant to say, sorry. So, yeah, I don't blame Bly at all for not going for any type of early scout. Pool now in production. It was a gas before Pool, because, of course, he needs the Speedlin to deal with this. He is preemptively assuming this type of build is coming out of the STC. The STC will get lucky with his scout and scout his opponent first. And is he going to try and drop it? He is. Pool has not finished. The drone is coming down to deal with this. And great positioning out of this bunker. As you can tell, the bunker is obviously blocked from that side and by here. So it's going to be very hard for these drones to get in there and surround him and all that good jazz. It does get cancelled though. STC realizing he's probably not going to stay alive, and now of course he wants some drone kills. He wants the blood. He wants it. I forget about this sometimes. Let me just do this. Ooh, and he gets taken out. Behind this, we have no more Reapers. We have a reactor factory being added on with the command center. So it is going to be some Hellions like we've seen every time in terms of his follow-up. And he wants that drone. Oh, he's got 2 more shots left. Nope. Of course, the Reaper can regenerate, so he's going to regenerate some health. If he gets some Zerglings as well, that's, you know, it's not that. That's pretty cool. It's better than nothing. There's the command center. Reactor factory about to be swapped over. Might as well produce some Marines while you're at it with the Widowmine. Widowmine takes 40 seconds, so that's okay. And, ooh, actually, this is a new build. We haven't seen this build. It's going to be maybe a Widowmine Marine drop. It could be an elevator. It could just be a one medevac drop. This will be interesting, though. The STC will have to add on. Okay, there it is. Command center finishes, and that frees up some supply. He was about to be short on supply. Look at that. He has, like, no units, and then he's just like, yeah, let's go build that bunker. There you go in. Borrows that just in case. This Overlord does survive. Oh, that was close. And there's sadly nothing here to actually scout. He could have left the command center, but I don't think that's really worth it. More units flying. Wait. He does. He's just got Overlord speed. And this is interesting. This is one of my teammates, Shibby. does something similar. Of course, on a big map like this, overload speed is actually quite cool, because you can just run in, scout something really fast, and run straight back out. And if the overload dies, you can just move another one into position pretty easily. Now, the third base has been scouted for the SDC. We have another gas being added on for Bly, so that is two gas production. And he could add on his lair soon, if he pleased. I don't know what he's going to go for. We have a group of Marines now coming, and... Did we have a wood medevac? Yeah, we did have a medevac. There it is.
Our forces are under
I
attack.
Don't think he spotted that. He was looking down here. But I don't think he realized that there was actually a widow, a medevac. And here it comes. One widow mine is going to get dropped. Is Fly going to realize? And bam, that gets four kills. Very nice indeed. The second one is headed towards the main. I don't think Fly is reacting. And get ready. And four kills on that one still. That was five drone kills. So that's pretty cool. There is a spore crawler here. He's going to pick it up and save his widow mine, because that is a true general. Leave no man behind, guys. Respect the work ethnics of the Koreans, yo. And he saves both of them and can boost in a second just to make sure they do survive indeed. Boost past the queen, yo. Boost past the queen. There it is. Because, of course, queens do some decent damage to medevacs, and they have good range for their anti-air, so we could have some widow mines being borrowed once again, and the medevac could go down. One more shot. Fast reactions coming with the STC does keep it alive. Baneland Nest is in production, so it looks like we could have a Baneland bus. There is a tank, there is no wall, there is one bunker, and a little group of Marines. The STC could see this massive group of... He does. He's going to know something that's a bit fishy about that many units. The Baneland Nest is not being spotted either, so that gives Bly a bit of an advantage here in terms of information. We have one widow mine borrowed right below there, and the second... Ah, okay, there's the second. That has same amount of kills it had earlier. So it must have just been nothing. And is Bly going to go for this all-in? It looks like, well, it's not so much an all-in, but he's going for a super aggressive strategy here. We actually have Bly with his 1-1 far ahead of the STC's 1-1 as well. So he is taking this advantage to the bank, as Stefano would say. And 81 to 90 supplies. So the STC is actually ahead in supply, probably because there's so many Zerglings and not that many drones. And there it is, it's about to finish, and bam, it does get cleaned up. That was very close indeed. One widow mine borrowing right back here, it'll borrow before, and... Oh, wow, that was such close reactions from the from Bly there. Holy crap, that was so close. And this Viking, man, he's getting lucky with all these overlords. All the overlords are now pretty much on this side of the map. Looks like the STC is going to go put some heavy, heavy pressure on his opponent. We've got a lot of Zerglings over here. There it is. Bly setting that off so he can go in and kill it. But there are three tanks. There's actually quite a lot of Zerglings, a lot of Marines, and a nice little surround coming on some of the tanks. There's so many Zerglings. We'll finish this off. Maybe one tank left, and STC is forced to pick up. But once again, the Bly is still really, really short on supply. In comparison to his opponent, that is. Third, now target for Bly. He's coming down for it. Is he going to morph in some Banelands? And there is also a drop up by here. A couple of Marines and even a Viking flying around to get some kills. And yes, he will go in for it. He didn't make any Banelands, so the CC does stay alive. But a lot of drones... SCVs just got cleaned, got killed off. And more will die as well. That is 15v11. There's a lot of damage being dealt over here. The Zerglings aren't rallied, they're not fighting. They're actually just chilling behind the hatchery. And now the STC, of course, has some pretty nice ground. He can do some decent splits through the minerals, lowering the surface area of the Marines, and of course dealing extra damage. He saves six Marines there and heads in towards the main. And he drops them in very nice position, and the units will have to run up by here and will take some damage from it. Okay, he just doesn't move them. Okay, that's fine. Third command center. No, third is now back to mine, and this Viking still pretty happy, chilling away, and main connections completely shut the drop down. So still 130 supply via 107 for the STC though, so like his attacks have been happening and failing, and he's still adding supplies. Says like that shows that Bly's not really doing something right. I think he's gone a bit overboard with his Zerglin production for the first half of the game, maybe even most of the game. But we do have Bane and Speed done. We have a lot of Zerglins. We do have some tanks. They are sieged up. There's only two though, and this does get spotted. Are we going to have some six splits? We are. There's another tank coming. It starts sieging up. Bainan's connecting on the tanks. Zerglin surrounding the last tank. The bunker is about to go down. Bainan's rolling into the mineral line. A lot of SCVs get taken out there. About 10 to be exact. 2-2 is about to finish for the Zerg. 2-2 for the Terran player is actually about quarter way done. A lot of damage was dealt there, but more damage to Bly as he has to replenish his entire army. There's a lot of gas, a lot of units just lost. The STC is, for example, they're even on harvesters, guys. So there's three command centers. We do need more medevacs though, definitely. Okay, we do have four now down here. Wall is being rebuilt, no bunker to add the finishing touch. And there is a tank that can siege up, like right for that, I guess. But nice position in here. The wall was down last time right by here, so the Zerglins did get a good opportunity to run in. There is not a full wall off here, there is a command center. The Zerglins run into the mineral line. The Banelands are going to come in and surround everything. STC has to have some very good control. He lifts up, tries to save his SCVs, but they get blown to pieces by the Banelands. The supplies still massively favor Bly, and he runs home with the rest of his army, which I feel is a very good decision there. He, 56 harvesters killed. 25 supply in terms of army, so the supply is really big there overall for the STC in comparison to his opponent. Time is now 6 o'clock. Okay. And sorry, I got cast another tournament in like 30 minutes. Alright, so 150 supply v120. I'm surprised that Bly is still down on supply. He's up at 4 bases. He's doing just a super low economy game though. We have 22 more Banelands morphing in. He's going all in here. We have plus 1 flyer attack as we have Mutalisks being added into the mix. There's tanks, they're not sieged. There's so many Banelands and Marines and they're all running. And some splits, the tanks get picked up. And the Banelands, not the best connections, but they did do okay. But the supplies are now 86 via 122. There is also a single medevac drop up here. They're targeting down the pool. The medevac's taking some damage. That is the last of the transfuses. It does go down. Stim, once again, they're going after the queens. Good choice. And if he gets the last queen, he can pick up. And no, the medevac goes down with it. We have two tanks here. They're not sieged up. The STC, what are you doing? One tank survives, the last one gets surrounded. And he does survive. The Banelands here are morphing, but they will get cleaned up just in time before they pop. And it's amazing that you actually get resources back when a Baneland is morphing and gets killed off. That really, like, I only learned that like a month ago. And this base is now being targeted down. STC taking his supply all the way to Bly's face, pretty much. He is gonna take it, definitely. And that fourth base should have got spotted by the drone march there. And another drop into the main. Bunch of Mutas will spot this, but of course they're not really going to be able to do much at this time. There's 2-2 Marines. These are 2-2 Marines for plus 1 Mutas. Oh my god, this is like the slowest fight in history. There's 2-3 Mutas left, 2. And the medevac does get taken out. The 2 Marines survive, Baneland blows up on them. There is still, of course, the main army, 152 supply, V97. He unsieges some of them. Great splits, actually. Really well split. They all cover each other pretty much. And some Baneland connections there take out a lot of the Marines, because the Marines are quite important. Otherwise, the mutas can just do as they please. Zerglin's trying to come around from behind, but no, they get killed off. GG is called, and the STC is now ahead in this best of seven. Whoa, that was a good game. Oh. Seriously, like, this is a really good series. Let me just change the scoreboard. So,